microphone.
Kentucky basketball. We just say pro sports, Chris, and she'll be here in a heartbeat.
But that only leaves foreign language.
Well, that's a tough one. I mean, half the time, I don't even know what they're saying.
You're forgetting someone.
Who?
Li Mei.
Li Mei? Of course. Aw, oh, she'll intimidate him with her ping pong skills. Also, Chris is out of touch with the Chinese culture. That'll get her fired up.
So now that we have all our teachers, what's your first move?
Me? I was thinking that you'd be the logical one to lead. I mean, you've played that role before. I mean, the National Honor Society?
I mean, that was a while ago, though, and now I'm pretty busy. I mean, I've got rehearsal. So, what about you?
Me? Oh, I couldn't possibly do it. I'm vegan.
Yes.
Who should we get?
I know. Whoever wins the Overlake Show will lead us.
Oh.
I mean, it takes great courage to come out here on the stage anyways, and a little bit of a reverence. They've already shown that they're great candidates by just being out here.
Yeah, that's perfect. So by the end of the show tonight, we're gonna have our revolutionary leader.
And have the Chen Dynasty overthrown. Without further ado, let's bring out the candidates of the Overlake Show 2016.
Presenting our featured singer of the night, Mr. Not President, Jeb Bush.
Play all of my life.
Yeah, he did, man. But he was so into war, dude.
Oh, dude,
what? Fight.
I tried all our usual stuff, man. Gave him a little bit of the stuff.
He
wouldn't budge. So you know what I did?
What you did?
Played him a song, man. After I played this song, at the end, he was like, man, geez. Something like this.
Thank you.
pick up girls. That's so good. Okay. The watermelon. Girls, they are like the watermelon. Okay? Look at that. Good watermelon, inside red, juicy. Yeah, sometimes they have the black seed.
Oh, good.
But if you want the white seed, there's a lot here. But the true way to find a girl is to do the dance.
The dance?
Grasshopper, there is a mating dance.
Oh, yeah.
Ladies?
Oh, no.
Are you ready?
There's a door. stage right. Oh my gosh, it's so typical, right? Oh, Andy and Jackie, they're so sweet. Matt Horvat, do you have a policy about this?
So much like me. Jinx! Jinx again! Our mental synchronization can have a quick exclamation.
A trio!
You and I were meant to be.
She seems so nice.
Will you marry me?
Yeah, you're fired. Are you crazy? Yes!
The cold never bothered me.
Strong! 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 Strong!
Audience members, calm down!
This is the basement party.
Oh.
Snuffles. Dad used to send a secret surgeon agent. Tuck me in with it every night.
Okay. You might want to put it in the washing machine every once in a while to get your tears.
No!
Alright, well, if you were in charge, Dr. Carson, if you were in charge of Overlake, what three things would you change?
Three things I would change? Let me think. Number one, I do think everybody should have guns. That'd be a good idea. More guns, more safety, am I right? Secondly, I think announcements should just be cut out, straight out. No more announcements. You just have Facebook, that's good. And finally.
Oh, I'm sorry, you're too slow. You're not gonna be able to say your third thing. You, what three things would you change?
So, given the current state of affairs of Overlake, I'd say that probably the first course of action I'd take is abolishing the S by BR. And the second thing I'd probably do is start teaching creationism in science class. All the liberal jargon of, you know, molecules and all that. And I have to agree, you know, guns would make campus a lot more safe. Teachers should have them, students should have them, fifth graders should have them.
Can I call my dad?
All right, thank you very much. I feel kind of sorry for that Jeff Bush guy.
Yeah. All right, let's bring out our next group, the 70s hippies.
Yeah.
Welcome, man.
Welcome,
man.
All right. So, where did you guys come from?
Well, you know, we're both from Santa Cruz. We met each other in high school. We were really united by our message for peace. After high school, all these people telling us to go to college, man.
Nah.
Nah, man, we're on a mission.
We decided that we needed to spread peace, man.
We went wherever the wind took us, man. Just going place to place, town to town.
We even went one place, man. It was so cold, I had to button up my shirt.
Oh, yo, I remember that day.
That was a rough day,
man. It
was
hard life.
Yeah, it's not a fun life.
So, where do you guys actually think you are right now?
Well, we don't really know, man. We go where the wind carries us. We travel from one town to the next, just trying to spread peace. We don't even know what year it is, dude.
Time is a construct.
It's an abstract. Therefore, the man who believes in time cannot be truly happy.
Well, what are your opinions on drugs and drug enforcement?
Man, it's nourishment. It's from Mother Nature. It all starts on this earth. And it all comes from this earth. We have to nourish our minds and our bodies. So we
Alright, well, with your opinion on peace, how would you achieve peace on the Overlake campus? Finally, if you guys were in charge of Overlake, what three things would you change?
Oh, well, the first one's easy, man. Legalize all substances. I think that you need all these for an effective learning environment, man.
Gotta let the mind expand. Hamper it, man. Let it be free.
Next, clothes are optional, man. Like, you know, you wear whatever you want or whatever you don't want, man.
Express yourself however you choose, man.
Expression is the key to peace. And finally, we would sell substances in the campus center. All five.
could be at peace, and we could have
all right, well, thank you, Karen, for coming to join us today.
Are you part of the band?
We'll see you later. Yeah,
are you, you're fighting against me. We're out of here.
We're out
of here. We're out of here.
Thank you. All right.
Take the coin, put the coin in the jar, throw downstairs. Sound it, think it's your baby name.
What was my name?
Waste my time.
Lovely. Well, how and where do you pick up girls?
Oh, math homework.
Confucius, what would be the worst thing for someone of your country to be allergic to?
Oh, I know this one stupid girl. She go here, she allergic to rice and soy sauce. Yeah, her name is Michelle Zhang, see you?
Sounds like a hard life. Well, Confucius say that there is always a way of solving problems without violence. Is this actually true?
When did I say that? Where's the MLM?
We cut hair? Yeah. Hey, Ruski! Brusky! Brusky! The buzzer! Brusky! I have the buzzer!
Why did you choose the song Let It Go?
Because I am Elsa.
So why are you called the Seaman?
We yeah.
Selective jurors questioning them is determining do they not favor the law which prosecution seeks to enforce.
Yeah.
Do residents of this state have a right to carry handguns openly on their hips without applying for or receiving a permit?
Yeah.
Can lawmakers enact legislation for any permit in the public interest, or are they limited to those functions to which they've been delegated specific powers?
Yeah.
Can Hillary change?
No.
All right. Mr. Seaman, if you were in charge of Overlake, what three things would you change?
One, dress code. Two, more Venus in campus center. Three, more barbers.
Whiskey.
What's the last thing you do before you go to bed at night?
We swim.
What's the first thing you do when you wake up in the morning?
What's your favorite part about swimming?
Yeah.
Do you like America so far?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Lucas is here.
Thank you very much, Steven.
Nice to see you. When we come back, we will hear speeches from all five of the candidates, so be ready for that.
Yes.